Ridri makadoro bojakata ya bazeke. Rimande zeguda karabo jogoto. Rimandro bozikri makado. Yes, internet is trying to go, but we are reconnecting. Internet tried to go, but we reconnect. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Imanduza bo kaboya mandri makabro bozikri bakade. Rega jagada reguzo godo. Ibra bazundere bakabo. Some of you up to now, you don't know how many altars a certain lady is raising against your marriage. There is a transmission that is coming. But what the Lord is bringing in my spirit is very dangerous for this public domain. It's very dangerous for this public domain. Some of you, you are involved in heavy spiritual warfare. Makabu jamando krobozikata. Rebazete rebakabu. Ramu jegedehe. Rimando robozaba. What I am seeing is something dangerous here. Irebozekata rabaha. Mandozi baha. Oh Lord Jesus. Oh Lord Jesus. Oh Lord Jesus. Oh Lord Jesus. What I am seeing here. It's very dangerous. It's very dangerous. You don't know how far people have gone just to raise a market order against your business. How far the people have gone to raise an order to take you out of your own marriage. But I need you to understand, child of God. Oh, Makabosha. I need you to understand that God is operating. And because God is operating, the devil cannot be able to do nothing. He cannot be able to stop you. He cannot be able to fight you. We are on divine protection, and I pray protection is your portion in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The Almighty God is going to give you the protection that you need. You are getting a protection. It shall be a protection order against every altar in the mighty name of Jesus. So listen to me. Whatever is pursuing you, whatever is fighting you in your family, in your community, in the place of your operation, today, by the grace of the Lord, in the name of Jesus, God is going to move in the supernatural. Glory to the name of the Lord. I pray that divine protection will come upon you. Some of you, the altar identifies with your name. With your name, Mando Shabakabo, Yeketere Bakabro Bozeketere Bakabo, Regusha Mande Kebra Bazuta Rabaha. So it's very important. This is the only reason why you, as a child of God, you must always make it a point that the first altar you raise, you always express your confidence in the cross of Calvary by what? Releasing your tithe unto the Lord. Number two, you know also how to connect into the anointing of the prophet that is over your life. Very, very important. People of the world, they have understood how to do these things. They know how to do. You know, let me tell you something. When sacrifices are made, these people, they give sacrifices to the gods they don't know and the god they don't see. If they're going to shed the blood, they'll kill a chicken and shed the blood and drop it on the ground. They don't count it a waste. They count it as an offering. They count it as an appeasement. But today the Lord is going to help you. Now, let me tell you something. There is one thing also the Lord must help you from. You must be protected from what I call the spirit of vengeance. Spirit of vengeance comes as a result of the mistakes done by our forefathers. Our families, people went ahead of us. They did some wrong things. They killed people. They bewitched people. They destroyed other people's marriages. They did some funny things. So the spirit of vengeance is now avenging over their generation when they are long gone. And we are seeing Lamentation chapter number 5 being fulfilled. Makabo Shamando, which says that, and our forefathers sins and they are no more, and we bear their consequences. But I'm here to tell you that you need divine protection from the Almighty. This is the only reason why you need divine protection. Marriages have become what? A war zone. Your mother-in-law comes to the house, she drops something in the toilet and she flushes it, and immediately there is a commotion in your home. Your mother-in-law walks into your bedroom and she changes your linen. Mando Shaboha. I'm seeing somebody here already. Your mother-in-law came to your house and she changed your linen without permission. You were not sick. You did not want her to change them. You did not ask her to do that. But the linen was changed as she came. And since then, there has been serious destabilization in your marriage after the linen was changed. Makabu jamando kebra bazuta. Why? Because the linen was not only changed, but the changing of the linen, it also meant that as you come in those beds, in those beddings, you were coming in the altar that is controlled by her, so that your marriage can be controlled by her. But today I come in the authority of the Almighty, that the power power of that altar right now is being broken in Jesus' name. And you shall be protected by the Almighty in Jesus' mighty name. Glory to God. There are children who are suffering. They are never healthy at all because of the altar of the mother-in-law's called their gogos. Marabo Jakatayabaha. But God shall protect your children. God shall protect you. God shall protect your marriage. God shall protect. There are some of you that are seated here. You can never even progress in whatever you are doing. Why? Because there is an altar which you must be protected from. You have never addressed it. You have never mentioned it. You have never asked for God's protection. As everything you are doing, there is a challenge in your life. But I come to let you know today, in the mighty name of Jesus, that the Almighty God is going to help you. The Almighty God is going to move in the supernatural. In the mighty name of Jesus, hallelujah. I pray that may the Almighty God come and give you the mighty protection that you need in Jesus' name. So listen to me. A lot of us, we sit here and we think the things of God are just automatic. No, you have got to express your confidence and your faith in them. Scripture is written, but does not mean that if it is written, it will work automatically. You must know how to provoke it. You must know how to believe in it. You must know how to practice. You must know how to confess it. You must know how to live in it. That's why many people know the Bible, but they are struggling. Many people know the Bible, but they are poor. Many people know the Bible. They die with the Bible in their mouths. They suffer with the Bible under their armpits. And they are poor and the business cannot move. Why? Because they are lacking the knowledge of a particular altar they're not protected from. How many of you have been thinking about altars? Altars is a place of power. Altars is a place of transaction. Altars is a place where exchange takes place. Altars is a place of spiritual traffic. Makabo shakata. An altar is a place of legislation. It's a place of spiritual judicial powers. That when the enemy comes, releases a legislative law to work against you, to work against your marriage, to work against your business, and immediately that is released, your car that has been running well, all of a sudden, boom, it dies, and you wonder why. Why is my car dying? You find that your workers are stealing from you. Your workers are running away from you. Your workers don't want to do nothing for you. You are wondering, why is my thing not working? There is a market order. And I'm feeling very strong. Yes, my daughter is like, what does she want in the main bedroom? She want to raise an altar. She want to put an altar. And it's a rivalry altar. That altar is called the rivalry altar. When you sleep on those beddings, immediately you and your husband, you are like a cat and a rat, and you don't know why you cannot agree. A man who you had so much, such a sweet relationship, all of a sudden you are like oil and water, and you don't understand. The rivalry altar is working against you. This is the altar that makes a woman to answer like she has just drunk whiskey, or she's possessed by the demons of Legion. She will shout like she wants the voice to run when she's shouting at the husband, and the husband will fight as if he has never beaten a person before and is rehearsing now to kill a person. Because why? This rivalry altar, it can make you to become like an animal and do things you're not supposed to do. It's a rivalry altar that will make a husband not to eat the food of the wife. It's a rivalry altar that will make the wife and the husband not to sleep together for 3 months because they are angry for the things they don't understand. They forget that they're husband and wife, but there's a rivalry altar that is fighting them. And most of these rivalry altars, most of the times, are brought in by in-laws. In-laws have brought this thing. And sometimes it's brought in by friends who are jealous of you. That's why I repeat to you, any person that is jealous of your progress is the entry point to your attack. Any person who does not rejoice that your husband loves you is an entry point to your marital attack. Any person who does not rejoice that you are prospering is an entry point to financial attack. Any person who does not celebrate when you are being promoted at work, this is an entry point for your professional attack. So you must know the entry points and you shut them. Oh, Rabo Shakata Yaba. Oh, Rabo Shakata. Oh, Rabo Zeke Tereba Kaboya Mandri Makadoya Bazeka. Father, we give you glory in Jesus' name. We rebuke every plan of the enemy right now in Jesus' name. We rebuke whatever is not from God. Glory to Jesus. Harabo shakata yabaha. Rebo zokoto yomondri makaboya mandri makade. Rego zokoto. Rebuja mandri makade. Rego dorobo shakata. Yes, Lord, in the name of Jesus, we give you glory. Mando shaka taraba jeke terebaha. Mama rabo joko toya mande. Come on, I want you to pray for protection right now. Glory to the name of Jesus. Start to pray for protection. Protection against every altar in my life, every altar in my community, in my neighborhood, in my family, in the name of Jesus. I pray for divine protection over my life, over my business. Mando zeka toya mandri makabo. Rebuja mando krobo zeke terebaka proposita. Rego joko toya mandri makade. Rebozota. Riga gagara bojaka taya mandri mazoto. I pray for divine protection right now by the anointing of God. My Jehovah, mighty God. Mando zeka toya mandere bagaboha. We bring down every 10 altars of the evil one right now by the anointing. Imando jagada krobo zikri makade. Irabababa rabo joko toya mandri makadoro bozikata. Pray right now by the anointing. Release the grace of the Lord. Release the touch of God right now in the name of the Lord. I pray, mighty Jehovah, move in the supernatural. Let the anointing of God flow right now. Hallelujah. Regu joko torobozia ireboja mandri makadere bazoka tayabaha ibrabazota. Holy Ghost, now may you speak right now. May you touch somebody, move in the supernatural in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. Ireboja mandri makadorobo joko toyabaha ibabababarabo joko torobozikri makado ikataraba zebra bakadaraba jenda riko torobozika ireboja mandri makadorobo zekri makado iraboja mandrobo kodorobo. Father, I pray. I release the anointing of the Lord. Mandezi gado kebra bazuta rabagaba. Father, release the anointing of the Lord, the power of the Holy Spirit right now. I frustrate every yoke of bondage. My Father, my God, in the name of the Lord. Imando jagada. We bring down every altar. Whatever is not of God, Father, we come against it. Whatever has been planted. Mando zekri makado robo zekri makado. Ibabababarabo jakatarabaha. Everything that the enemy has planted to monitor you in your home. Marabo jamande. Come on, pray right now. Pray wherever you are. You that are watching me, pray in the spirit right now in the name of the Lord. There is a word that is coming. Pray in the spirit right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I rebuke every plan of the enemy. I rebuke whatever is not from God. Mando shata. Igadoya mande. Krobo zeke terebakabo. Rebabababa rabo zokotoro mondri mazota. Ireboja mandri makado robo zikri makado. Irabababa rabo zeke terebakaboha. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. We close every entry point right now. Protect us, oh God. Divine protection from every altar. Divine protection not from rivalry altar. Divine protection from water altar. Lord, Father, Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray, Father, palace altar, oh God. Polygamous altars, in the name of Jesus. Marketplace altars. Father, in the name of the Lord, I thank you for the wisdom. I thank you for the glory. Poverty altar, right now. Rivalry altar in the name of the Lord. Mando jeketereba ikadorobo zikri makadorobo jandarabaha yebuza mandri makadorobo zikri makado rebabababababa rabo zeketereba kaprobozuda ireboja mandri makadorobo zikri makado. Father, I give you glory and I give you honor in Jesus' name. Mando zeketereba kaprobozuda ireboja mandri makadereba zokotorobo ziaha ikatatatataraba kebreba kadorobo zikri makado. Remuza mandri makado. Yes, Lord. Listen to me. The things that the Lord is showing me right now, they are too heavy. They are too heavy for this. They are too heavy and too private. Some of you, I'm going to start inboxing you. Makabo shakata. The Bible says that the spirit of a prophet is subject to a prophet himself. Because there are things that the Lord is showing me right now. Some of you here are married people, and I cannot just put this thing on a public domain like that. Because what I am saying right now, I want you to hear me. Some of the things are strange gifts that were brought into your home. Strange gifts, strange clothes. I see t-shirts, I see clothes, I see things. The same gift that was was brought in your home by your husband has brought so much rivalry in your home without even you realizing, because that is the order from the girlfriend who is trying to uproot you and to bring a rivalry between you and your husband. So that is a rivalry order planted in your home. Some of these things were brought by a woman. You women brought it into the house, and the minute you came into the house, you lost interest in your husband. There was no more peace again, and the husband, a man, is here right now and is thinking, what went wrong? There was something traded in form of a gift, but the gift came from a wrong person. Makabusha, Rigo Zeke Terebaha, we are destroying and dismantling by the power of God. Listen to me. Some of you must learn to watch around your house. See some of the things that look strange. See the gifts you cannot trace where they come from. See the things which your husband will bring, and you know by no means he cannot buy this thing, and it was given by somebody who is wrong, and they bring them into the house. Marabosha, even the people that come into your home and decorate your home, your in-laws come, your sister-in-law come, whoever come, your friend come, and they bring you a thing and they plant it in your home. Immediately they plant it, no, bring this flower pot here, this is very nice for you, and as they put it there, it become a thick rivalry altar, and since the thing was put there, you and your husband, there is no peace, and every time there is a problem between you and your husband call your very friend all the time to report you. The same person who put a decoration in your home. Wake up, and you must smell coffee. I'm a spiritual man. I understand how this thing operates. You need to pray for protection. You need to pray for God to open your eyes, and you need to demolish every altar in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Makabuja mando kebra bazu. Riga zoko toro mondri mazoha. Rivalry altars, they can make every person who come into your life to find you like a person that is so problematic, and you argue over over nothing where there is no reason to argue. You find yourselves arguing. Why? Because there is a rivalry or that is against your marriage. But today, by the anointing of God, the challenge that we have, you prefer to go and drink beer, spend money in beer, than raising an altar unto the Lord. You choose to take money and go and put it into humanizing and manizing instead of giving it to the Lord. Whenever you give an altar to the Lord, to you it is a waste, because you expect God to operate just like that for you, because he's a God. Listen to me, let me help you. God had to kill his own son, Jesus. God in his own power, he could deliver this world without sending Jesus to the cross and putting a nail on him. But the Bible always teaches us responsibility, sacrifice, commitment, and faith. He said Jesus is becoming a sacrifice on the cross, who is dying for you as a sacrifice. And you need to know. That's why Paul said, I want to know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his suffering. I want to know him, and I want to fellowship with him in his suffering, and I want to know the power of his resurrection. You need to understand me very well. A lot of you, the challenge that you have is that you want the easy way. You don't want to pray. You don't want to raise altars. You don't want to give to the Lord. You don't want to give your tithes. You don't want to. You want the easy way. You want God to understand, to come to your terms. No, God will never come to your terms. You will go with the terms of God. If you are serious about what you are seeing in your life, you go by the terms of God. Let me tell you something, child of God. Makabu jamando kebra bazu. Regu jamande kebra bazo torobo kaboha. Fatima, there is a person here following me by the name of Fatima, and the Lord is coming, is releasing something in my spirit right now. Fatima, the Lord is speaking to me, and he's saying to me right now that there is a protection that he has released upon you, and this divine protection is much needed, because so much has happened in your life. Marabo jamando, kebra baha, regu jama. Fatima is following me on this place, and I'm here to tell you that there is a divine protection that is coming upon you. Listen to me. There are losses that took place in the past, and there were more losses that the enemy wanted to cause in your life, because there is an altar that claimed things into your life. And the Lord is saying, I'm releasing that divine protection upon you. I'm releasing that divine protection upon you. Glory to the name of Jesus. Makabu jamande kobra bazuta rabakabu. Regu jamande kebra bazoto robo jabaha. Rego zaka taya mandri mazoto roboha. The altar that collects things from you, that you work hard, you put things, and whenever you get something, the enemy bring complication complication. Actually, complication is English. Let me talk in spiritual terms. Brings confusion and brings disturbance and attack on what God has put in your hands. Glory to the name of Jesus. I'm speaking to you, Terence Tafazwa Chibaya. I'm speaking to you, Terence Tafazwa Chibaya. Makabo Shamando Kebra Bazota. That power that sees you go up, possess, get things. And the same power that sees that comes to collect the things that you possessed. To me, that is an altar of poverty. An altar of poverty is not a lack of money. Money may be there. An altar of poverty is an altar that does not want a person to keep what they get. And I want you to pray against that altar, my son, in the name of Jesus. Makabushakata. Ribazonda kaboya mandri mazoka. Reguja mande kebra bazoto rogo kabra bazoha. Rimakoto yebra bazoto ya mandri mazokata. Rebaza mundu koroboja. Rega zokoto ya mandri makado. Rego zakata. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, mighty God. Nene Shongwe, whatever has troubled other people, your siblings and all that, thus says the Lord, I'm going to open a door for you. And I'm going to lead you by my divine protection into your destiny. There is something I'm seeing in Nene Shongwe, that there are dreams and the things you want to achieve, but provision is not there. You are lacking provision. You are lacking provision. And the Lord is saying, I am going to divinely protect the people who are supposed to help you. Because certain people who are supposed to help you, they fall off by the wayside. Makabosha. Bongi, where that is a prayer you need to pray right now. The market otter, Marabojaka Tayabosa, the market otter does not attack you directly, does not attack your husband directly, attacks the people where you are supposed to network with and link with. Attacks the sources, the places where you are supposed to be multiplied, the places where you're supposed to operate from. That's where the attack gets. And today you pray by the grace of the Lord to say, Father, the network that you have given to me, my family, for business, today, Lord, in the name of Jesus, I speak divine protection against any altar that fights them. Makabo shakata. Yebra bazota raba kabro bozikri makado. Remando zigada kabro bozoto. This is the only reason why I'm going to tell you. I don't allow a stranger to come and plant any plant in my yard. I don't care who you are. You can be white, you can be yellow, you can be green. I don't allow you to come and plant anything in my yard. I will plant my plant myself. Because if I buy the plant, I'll come and plant it. Not you to come to my yard and plant a plant in my yard. Because planting of things in the ground, including plants. Oh, Makabosha. Remember, every tree in the spiritual world has got its own meaning. Mando zekri makadoro bojeka tayabaha. So it's very important for you to understand. Not everybody must come and, no, this is a nice yard. I've brought you a plant. Let me plant it myself. And they dig and you think they are showing you love. And they plant a tree. I don't believe in that. That's why I can tell you something. Anybody who does that, it takes dominion and control over a place. That's why certain people who planted trees in the cities, even politicians who laid whatever in certain places, the first brick, they planted trees in certain places. It's difficult to move them out. It's difficult to move them out. It's difficult to erase them because they have a plant. They have an altar. There is something before they go to plant that tree. There is something that has happened. There is something that they have put there. So today, by the grace of the living God, I'm releasing the anointing and the power of God upon you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. There is an increase of protection. Glory to the name of the Lord. Makabu jamande kebra bazuta. Rego jamanda kabro bozuta rabakabu. Reba baba rabozoto yamandri mazuka. Regu jamandri makadoro bozeba. Francis Kachiruane, wherever your name has been mentioned and being discussed, mando zikata, to change the season you are in, the Lord says, I'm increasing amazing protection. Makabozeke tere bakabro bozoto. Regujamando kebra bazo. Ragujeke tere bakaboha. Rebo, there is a protection coming upon you right now. Maraboza mande kebra bazuta. Rigazoko toyo mondri mazikata. Father, I give you glory and I give you honor. Mbeteke, there is a protection that is coming over you. Marabosha, that in your working place, whatever the enemy plan against you shall not prevail. Riguza gada kabra bazoto. Baba baba rabo jaka taya mandro bozeke tere bakabo. Mando zikri makadoro bozeke tere baha. The Lord is saying to you saintly that you see people fall by your side from the left and the right. You see them fall. You see them fall. You see your enemies fall. You hear so many things happening even within your building, your offices and your working places. But that says the Lord, my protection is upon you, said God. There is a divine protection the Lord is bringing upon you. This is regarding your working place. Marabo shaba hikato ya mandri mazukata rebuja mando kebra bazukata regozoko torobo sabaka bora mandri mazuta rebozo kotorobo. But you need to take a very strong prayer and you pray against the market order. Mandozi gada, what want to control your transaction? There is so much ideas in your mind. There is so much the Lord has put in you which you want to discharge, but the market order is trying to limit your income. Marabuja mando kebra bazoha. Thus says the Lord God, as we demolish that market order, I am releasing a mighty, mighty and divine protection over you, that as you walk from now forth, saith God, things are gonna work in your favor, and the arrows of the enemy shall not prevail financially. Makuya bozekato rebra bazute rebakabo marabo jakata higadoya mandri makuba rebo zoto robokaba marabo jaka higadoya mandri mazoko toyaba ireboza mande kebra bazo irekozoko toroboha. The order in the village that has tied your hands, tied your legs, and closed your face. Makabuja mando krobozika teyaba rimando zikato ya mandri mazo raguja katere bakabro bozoto raboza mandri makadoro bozika ribozoko toro bozikri makado ramande zigado krobozikri makado. That altar over you, Christine, is getting broken. Marabozika toya mandri mazo regoja katarabazikata. There are two altars I'm seeing right now. It's an altar of poverty and poverty, or altar of death. Marabozika tayaba rigozabaha. Poverty is not the absence of money, but poverty is a denial to keep what comes into your hands, says the Spirit of the Living God. And the altar of death, it's not dying physically, mando zeka toya bada, but everything that begins in life, everything a person wanna do is like they don't exist. Nothing in life exists, but life is there. Marabo jamando kebra bazoha. And the Lord says this morning, I am releasing divine protection over you. I'm discharging my angels around you. Marabo jama, to bring this war to an end, saith God. Mando zeka toyabaha. And we are silencing, says the Spirit of the Living God, every voice on that altar. Mandu zigado kebra bazuta. This morning you're gonna read Psalms 91. Mando zeketere bakabo. You're gonna read the all of it. Mando, and after that, you're gonna speak into the village. And you say those two altars, the altar of poverty and the altar of death, right now I erase my name. I demolish them in the mighty name of Jesus. Glory to the name of the Lord. Makabuja mando kebra bazu. Reba zagu daraba. Noktula magagula. The altar that has captured you, it has just let you go. Mando zegada. Where you are right now, your eyes are tearing. Where you are right now, you are vibrating. Noktula magagula. Mando jabukadu. Rebra bazu ketere bakabu. Raguja. Raguja rabaha reboza kuda kebra bazo makaba zeketere bakabo rimandoza regozoko torobo rebaka dorobo zaba. The altar that has captivated you and put you into slavery, it is getting broken by the anointing of the living God. Imando zekata rebrobozoko toya mandri mazekete rebozoto robokabra bazo. Father, I give you glory. Mighty God, I give you honor. Jehovah, you are powerful. Jehovah, you are great. I worship you this morning because you are the great God and you are the mighty God. Mando sabaka doya mandri mazota. Ibre bazoko torobo zekri makadoha. Reboza mandri makadere bazoko torobo zaba. The Lord is raising is raising help for you. Tres mshala. The Lord is raising help for you. Makabu jamande kebra bazute de bakabo. When I go into the realms of the spirit, I don't know how you found yourself into the business that you are doing right now. But the Lord is showing me right now that there was a time of rest in your life where you rested and everything was okay. Until you reach a point where you almost like you hit the wall. And when you hit the wall, like everything was falling apart. And you had to stand up and you say, I'm going to do something. And you started to get involved in the business that you are in. And in the beginning, the Lord started to flourish it. And from nowhere, something came. And it started to blow like a negative wind. That everything that you gather, when you put it into something, the enemy want to disturb everything that you are doing. And want to take away that which you are gathering and you are saving. You served some time. And whatever you served, the enemy wanted to come and collect. And that says the Lord God today, that the altar, the market altar that has been working against your transactions, today by the grace of the Lord, I prophesy over you. The Lord says it is broken. Makuya boza. There shall be a divine protection that will come upon you. There are some of you here that are watching me. You must be protected from the altar of death. Death does not mean losing your life, though it promotes also physical death. But a lot of you, a dead person has nothing to their account. A dead person, no one wants to correspond with them, to marry them, or to associate with them. They are people whereby you are ignored permanently by the world and by the people. Your efforts are ignored. You are as dead. I pray that that altar of the dead is broken in the mighty name of Jesus. Makuya bozeka toya mandri mazu. Rego jokoto robokiba. Mandeziga. There is ayabo sheke tere bakabo mando zikado ya baze mando zekri bakado. And a lot of you that are watching me right now, marabo sheke tere bazeba. The Lord will need to protect you from the spirit of jealousy. Marabosha jealousy rigo shaka taraba. And I repeat, and I'm going to tell you this. Any person that come in your life and is jealousy is the entry point to your attack. When you keep them, you have kept your attack. When you keep them, you have kept your attack. When you get rid of them, you have gotten delivered. Listen to me. When you get wrong people out of your life, wrong things stop to happen. Mando zeka toyaba. Listen to me, my daughter. I want to take a bottle of olive oil. Maybe my son is listening to me right now as well. Maybe your husband is with you. If he's not, please convey the message. I want you to take a bottle of olive oil. Rimozi gado. I need you to take this olive oil, this bottle. It must be a breakable bottle. A breakable bottle. Mando zigada. Rebuja mando kebrabaha. And you go right to the front of the house, not the back. The front of the house. And just opposite the front door. Mando zaba. I need you to pour that boat of water completely into the ground and let the oil sink in the ground. Mando zeka toraba zekri bakado. Hiraboja. I need you to do that. Zandile dube. I need you to pour that oil. Let it go right into the ground. Because I'm going to tell you something. Ribo zeke terebaha. We are sucking and are resting. Mando shaba. Because the enemy wanted to birth pains. To birth pains, I'm not speaking to pregnancy, to birth pains of life into that yard, into your home. That when it begins now, you cannot be able to control it. Marabo jamando kebra bazo. As you pour that oil in the ground, I want you to hear me. Irebo jaka tarabaha. As I'm speaking to you right now as a spiritual cover, the divine protection is over you and divine protection is over your children. Makuya bozeka toyaba. You are going to realize why I said this. Mando zika toya mandri mazoko toya baha. Rebo zika doye brabazoha. Hospital shall never be a place where you're going to become clients. Not by your children that you have. That's why I'm here to tell you that God is protecting you to what I call pain which the enemy wanted to breathe in your family, makabo shabaka boga, in your home, rigozeka toya bazika toyaba. You find a young girl, something go wrong in the stairs. You see the boy, something go wrong at school, and you see all those kind of stuff. And I'm trying to talk to you so that you may be able to understand, not to scare you. But as you do that, I'm releasing the mighty protection. Because listen to me, as the enemy meant it for you to be client of hospital, you shall be a client of nice restaurants and hotels. You go and eat, and after you eat, you rejoice with your family and you go home. I speak that divine protection over you in the name of Jesus. Take a bottle of olive oil today and you go front door of your house, not at the door, front door, straight front door, and you pour it completely, all of it, and you say, Lord, in the name of Jesus, I use this door as a point of contact. Any entry of pain in my house today, it is sucked by this ground in Jesus' name. Makuya bozikata mandozi rebro bozoko toya mandere bazaha regodo ya bozika toya mandri makoda reguja mandeke brabazotaraba. The altar of limitation, marabuja mande krabazu regozoko toro bozikri makado mandaraba. The makabo jeketereba, that altar of limitation linked to a altar of polygamy, marabu jamando, that has brought a lot of challenges in your life. Listen to me, Gugu. From now on, Gugu Ndukuya, from now on, listen to me. This is what the Lord is showing me. All the tears you have cried in the past as a result of the altar, whereby you were not preferred, mandoshaba, no matter what you tried to do, it's like there was an altar you were not protected from. Someone else walk into your space, and I mean in a marriage, in a relationship, walk into your space, and that altar of polygamy almost speak against you and get somebody in your place. Glory to the name of Jesus, because today, thus says the Almighty God, that your later part, oh Jesus, what I'm saying is powerful. Your later part shall be the part one of joy, where you're going to celebrate, Mando Shaba. Number two shall be the later part of financial prosperity. The things that were taken away from you, they are coming back in the name of the Lord. Marabuja makadova, ibrabazu terebakabro bozaha, iramozikri makando rebrabazoha. Listen to me, kumucho mndule. The market order that bring unnecessary expenses at a time when you need to gather, marabo shakataya, there is a divine protection coming on every business you're gonna put your hand on. I need you to get ready. In the next 90 days from now, as we are gonna conclude this year, rebo jama krobozika toya mandri mazutaya rebo joko toyo mandri mazo, as we conclude this year, marabo shaka, the altar, the market order, the Lord says, every market order that has been doing transactions that takes not to bring, or when there is a blessing, the market order collects some of the things unnecessarily, because certain people have been put on the ground when they need to come up and you need to bring them up. The Lord says, time has come when you're going to keep and gather this thing for yourself and for your family. For the Lord is not only going to prosper you, but is prospering all the people around you. Marabo shamando kebra bazuta, rebo joko torobo zikri makade, rebo zapa kaboya ma, market order, Matilda Koho, listen to me very carefully. The market order that has been doing negative transactions financially in your life and your family, thus says the Almighty God, that market order is losing power now. Makuya bozeka toya mando yebra bazutere bakabu reguja mando yebra bazo. That market order come as a result of the palace order. The palace order that brings a limitation, that people work hard but they don't see what they work for. But today, that says the Lord, it is beginning with you. You are breaking the iron ceiling and you are penetrating and you are going up and you are breaking the record, because the Lord says from today on, that market order that has been transacting negatively in your life and your family is getting broken in the name of Jesus. Listen to me. You're going to read Psalm 91 as well today. Reguzamande kebrabazoho. Rebozikri makado. Rebojeketere makaboha. Spelele neneshongwe is confirming the prophecy right now. She said, it is true, Daddy, I've got dreams, big ones, but I don't have provision. And that's exactly what the Lord showed me. Mandozika toyama. Kropozikri makadere bazota. Mama mama rabozoko toyama. Igadoya mandri mazoko tayabase. Ribozokoto. Imeoda, listen to me very carefully. Every altar of rivalry altars, you are hated without any reason. You are hated not only by your family members, you are hated without any reason. Sometimes even the people you need to work with, your colleagues, your friends, they just turn their back on you with no apparent reason. But I pray that the Lord, in the name of Jesus, is going to break that rivalry altar in your life today, and you're going to walk in the grace of God. Glory to God. Imando zeke tere bakabo rebo zugudu krama zekata rebo jamande kebo zika irebo zutara bakabo marabo jakata rebo zamando kumuchomduli. I come back to you once again. I'm receiving your transmission. It's like I'm in your working place right now. I see many altars in that place, but listen to me. That says the Almighty God, I will protect you from those evil altars. Marabosha, they are evil intentions all around. Makaduyaba, they are evil intentions all around. But that says the Lord God, my divine protection is upon you. I shall protect you from those evil altars, says the Spirit of the Lord. Mandosha mukado reguzuku tuya mandrimazo. There is jealousy, there is accusation. Maraboja, but there is a monitoring spirit. Mando, there is provocation. Imakaduya mando. The Lord says, remain still and know that I am God. I have released divine protection over you, and I shall not allow the enemy to put you to shame, says the Spirit of the living God. Imanduze gado kebrabazo. Ireguzamande kebra bazuta rebozoko torobozaba ranzu 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 queen. You may ask, you are asking questions right now. Your heart is filled with fear. Your life is filled with fear. Other people have even been advising you and talking to you to say maybe you need to do something. You need to go to a certain place and get washed. You need to a certain place and get cleansed. Listen to me. Even you, the fear has captured you. But I am here to tell you, my child, that the Lord says to you, my hand is upon you. My protection is makabosha. My protection is upon you. Glory to God. Ranzu, I'm speaking to you. Never be afraid of anything. Don't get the advice of going to any place for anything. There is nothing wrong with you. Thus says the Lord, I've released protection upon you and upon your children, says the Spirit of the living God. Trace Mushlala is confirming the prophecy. Said, it is very true, Daddy. I felt it every day, every time. I save money, just disappear. Mando Shabaha, that market altar that takes your money away is already disappearing in the name of Jesus. Makuya bozeka toyabaha. Rebro bozikri makadorobo shabaha. Spirit of jealousy, leave you now. Mando Shabaha. Yes, they must pack and leave. Glory to the name of Jesus. Mando zekri makadorobo shabaha. Hiba Makado ye mando robo zikri makado. Hirabo jakata rabakebra bazutere bakaba. Now listen to me. Oh, glory to Jesus. Every person that is here. Oh, Rabosha. If he's there, he's there, he's there. My son is there. And I pray that the healing has taken place in his body. I pray the Lord is healing him completely from that flu that he had. Do that in the name of Jesus. I pray that the Lord strengthen your body in Jesus' name. So today, together, take the body of oil and do what you need to do as I've instructed you, to the name of the Lord, to the glory of the name of the Lord, because that is very important. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The Lord is a great God. Yes, my son, I know you are there. God bless you. Yes, make sure you do what I've said you must do. Ladies and gentlemen, listen to me. Otters, it's something you don't stop doing. Business people are here. People are here. If you see me, I've been waking up every morning. Today is the day number 73. And I'm not planning to stop anytime soon. There is something we need to demolish. There is, you listen to me, when the enemy comes like a flood, we must raise the standard with our God. So we are here to tell the devil, your time is over. You are here. you are here. You know that there are certain altars you have sensed in your life that goes against you. And an altar is defeated by prayer one, by offering two. So you raise altars. I'm not going to tell you what you know what to do. All of you have got the bank account of the prophet. All of you know the bank account of bishop. I'm right here. You just say reference, family altar, market altar, polygamous altar, palace altar, water altar, whatever it is, do it as a prophetic word has come. I have taught you. The first thing you do, you show your faith in the prophetic word, so that now you are telling God, I believe in what you have revealed, and now I am going to walk into the manifestation of this prophecy. This thing the enemy want to do, you have stopped it, and I believe in the name of Jesus. So you must always know how to capture prophecy in the realms of the spirit. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Makabo Jamando. Some of you might be joining us for the first time. And if you are going to be doing any, you are going to be raising any altar, sending any seed regarding any altar that you want destroyed, or any confirmation of the prophetic word, Mando Shaba, the account number is right in front of you. It's very simple. It's very simple. You just use it and you send your seed. Reference, you must put it there. You must put Makabo Shaka Taraba Zekri Makadoro Boshaba. Yes, you're going to only attract good people with good intentions in your life, and we reject those with bad intentions. I agree with you. My daughter Ndukuya, I agree with you. My in-law, I agree with you. Ribozika Toya Mandri Mazotaha. Yes, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of the Lord. Glory to the name of Jesus. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. Now, as the word cometh, listen to me. Altars, it's something you don't stop doing. And I'm here to tell you that your giving must become natural. As a prophetic word comes, grab it. Take it in your spirit. Express your faith in the word. Glory. Makabo shaka tayabaha. Yebra bazuke terebaha. Go and prosper. The market altar, Olivia Pofa, the market altar that worked against you for a long time. You tried many things. I see plants. I see a lot of things that you try to do, to just try to do business and make it, and things could not work. Intentions of farming in the mind, wanting to farm, could not. Magabosha, listen to me. My washe, I'm going to tell you something. My washe, I'm closing on you. I'm going to tell you something, my washe. Magabosha, my washe, I'm going to tell you something. Riboshakata. There is an altar that the Lord has broken inside your home, the place where you live. When you come back, when you go into the house, now, after this morning, you're going to sense a shift. And there's going to be a shift in everything. I give you 5 days. Today is Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. On Sunday, you may give me a testimony and tell me there is something that is going to happen. Number one, there is a shift in your relationship with your husband. Number two, there is a shift, Makabo Shaha. There will be a shift in your planning, the togetherness. Riboza Gada Kaprobozika, Rebuja Mando Koprobozi. Listen to me. Because the issue is, there is something that is still after switching houses. You still carried and you did not know. You are not supposed to carry it, but you carried it. And that thing is losing power, my washer, because it came so strong that it could easily bring a separation in your family. But that says the Lord, it shall not happen. Glory to the name of Jesus. Makabo shaka tayabaha. Yabo sekata. Tabiso pofa, every altar that has promoted delay. That altar can never speak and mention your name again after today, in the name of Jesus. God is starting to work in his own way. Glory to the name of Jesus. Ladies and gentlemen, we need to come to the end. We will continue tomorrow. If we start now, we won't end. Say, my Father and my God, in the name of Jesus, I declare and I decree, every altar fighting my life, every altar disturbing my life, I break it, I destroy it. From today, I am free from every altar that is not of God, in Jesus' name. Amen. Listen to me. Now, you need to connect yourself to the altar of the Lord. You don't defeat an altar with a mouth without raising a new altar. You raise a new altar. As you break the older altar, you raise a new altar. So I need you to raise a new altar as you break the older altar. The account is in front of you. We raise our altars in this time with offerings, finances. Finances. The agriculturists in the Bible, they raised altars with animals because that's what they had. You don't have animals. We have got income. We raise altars with that. God bless you. Makabo shaka tayabaha. Yebra bazuka toya mandri makabro bozoko toya mandri makado. I bless all of you and may you have a great day further. Wherever you are raising an altar. Take this thing serious. All of you, the prophetic words, and you want to raise altars. Altars are raised all the time. Remember, I've taught you it's wisdom to give to God. Giving must be natural. The account is in front of you. And you put there. Altar. Reference. Market altar. You are releasing it for your business. Some of you need to go into heavy things. The Lord has already released you there. Oh, rako shaka tarabazeka toya mandri mazoko. Those tears, my daughter Gugu, they shall be turned into tears of joy. And I know that the Lord has turned everything into your favor in the name of Jesus. Makabuja mande kebra bazo tarabaha. Glory to the name of the Lord. Yes, Jesus. Yes, Jesus. You can go over this recording again whenever you feel like going over it again. God bless you and thank you for being here. Remember, we are the fire. We cannot suffer. Honor is from the Lord. And all I'm doing is making ministry attractive. God bless you. Oh, hallelujah. Enjoy your restoration. Tomorrow, we are continuing with divine protection. We are continuing with divine protection. And I'm going to be able to reveal to you in what area is the Lord speaking to us. Yes. Yes. Oh, glory. Oh, glory. She saw much of me. It's a one me love. My amor. In the close of my oh, she saw much of me. It's a one me. Oh. I'll be looking forward to receive you in the church this Sunday. Church is open. Everybody must be there. Today we have got our faith clinic at 11 o'clock. God bless you as you come. It is a joy to have all of you here. Continue praying, and each one of you, go and read Isaiah 61. Isaiah 61. Read Isaiah 61. Let the Lord help you. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Father. Oh, thank you, Lord. I love each one of you, and may God bless you. May God bless you. May God bless you. Those who are raising altars, go ahead, and you just do that. Oh, Jesus. Jesus. All those altars are broken. Yes, I agree with you. Market altars are broken. Polygamous altars are broken. The name of Jesus is being glorified right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes. Glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus. Glory to the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Oh, makabo shaka tayabo zeke terebaka brobozo torobokaba. Glory to Jesus, hallelujah. Things are turning around. Rivalry altars that makes families to fight. They are all over. Glory to the name of Jesus. They are all over. In the name of Jesus. Oh, glory to Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Yes, glory to Jesus. Let me listen to you. Things are turning around. Things are turning around. Need divine protection from the market altar, especially. You need divine protection. You need divine protection. You need divine protection. Business people, you need divine protection from the market altar. Every market altar in your family is broken now. In your business, your businesses are gonna move in a supernatural way. Glory to the name of Jesus. You're gonna experience a supernatural turnaround. You're gonna experience a supernatural turnaround. Oh, glory to the name of the Lord. You will experience supernatural turnaround. Glory to Jesus. Hallelujah. Supernatural turnaround. Supernatural turnaround. Supernatural turnaround. Supernatural turnaround. Supernatural turnaround. Glory to Jesus. Yes, the Lord is working already. The Lord is moving in a supernatural way. Oh, yes, God's protection is here. God's protection is here. Listen to me very carefully. You defeat these altars, first of all, by giving to the Lord, raising a new altar, connecting to the original altar of the Lord. Your business needs a market altar. Your family needs an altar. You have never gone so specific. Glory to the name of Jesus. Be so specific, be intentional, and let the Lord help you. Glory to Jesus. Father, we give you praise. Lord, we give you glory. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah. Tomorrow we continue on divine protection. I need you to continue following me. Tomorrow we continue on divine protection. Tomorrow we continue on divine protection. Glory to Jesus. Oh, God bless you. I'll join with you tomorrow morning again, 5 in the morning, on our 24th day of Thanksgiving. We are giving God thanks. In Jubilee, we need to have wisdom. In Jubilee, we're going to understand the operator of God. In Jubilee, we deal with things so that we may live in Jubilee in our peace, peacefully. Ignorance is the biggest enemy to God's children. Ignorance. Ignorance is the biggest problem. And we're not going to allow ignorance. Shimaka doya mandrupo zoko toya bazika. Oh, bless you. Oh, bless you. Oh, bless you. Thank you for being here. I love each one of you. Shalom. I need to gym for 30 minutes before I get to go to the church, to the office. God bless you. God bless you, Adelaide. God bless you. God bless you, Lady Howe. God bless you. God bless you all. Oh, what a blessing. I'm favored to have you as my daughters, Andile, and your husband as my just children. I love you so much, guys. Bless you. Thank you. Thank you, Kumucho. Yes, I appreciate you guys. Thank you also for standing with me. Thank you. Thank you, Matilda. I receive that so much. Thank you so much. I receive that. God bless you. Oh, yes, honor is from the Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God is good. I receive that blessing. Thank you so much. God bless you. You are a blessing, all of us. Yes. We are going to navigate this. Glory to Jesus. May God bless you. Have a good day, Father. Bishop Alex, your dad, Gio, logging out. Shalom.